doing?
You look so cool.
Likewise. Oh, thank you. I dressed up for the occasion.
Yeah, I see. I see.
God, you look cool. I feel like if you sing like you do, you have to dress like this all the
time. You know, you got to. All
right.
Well, look at that.
Look at
placeholders.
This. We got tea and ukuleles.
Yes.
I see you brought your Darren Criss wig.
I did.
I brought my LP wig.
The like extra version.
Yeah,
the,
me too.
The pre-abridged.
I wanted to dress for the day. It's a good thing I didn't wear my black jacket, because then it would have been too much. They wouldn't
that
know who
weird.
Is who.
Because we don't know each other well yet. We just we're like new friends. We've been like acquaintances for a while.
We've been on the periphery of each other's lives for a while.
Yeah.
But I think the people who are watching it don't really, I take this for granted being in the music industry. You don't think that writing music for other people is a part of that journey of like, oh, I guess I could do that. So I'm with you. That was me sort of.
Yeah, it's weird,
dancing.
Right?
Yeah.
That came when I thought my career, like I'd had two major label deals that didn't yield a record, you know, like, but I wrote a shit ton of songs. It was like a crazy amount of songs. So songs kept getting pulled from like my catalog to go to other people. And then I just was like, you know, actually it's really cool being a songwriter.
Do you get great, like I do. I get a lot of satisfaction when I hear other people sing songs
I've
written
yeah.
more than I would have if I did it.
Yeah.
I don't know if it's the same for everybody. Maybe there's some sort of like, I really should have cut that. Or
I never go like, I've never been like, I should have.
Yeah,
you know,
good. I
mean, maybe I've been lucky that, you know, I haven't had that song yet. Mm. It seems like
if you do, you just cut it. You don't play it for anybody. You go, this is mine, I'm sorry. No,
yeah,
I'm not
maybe.
For
yeah,
sale,
yeah, yeah.
Exactly.
So now, when you got Glee, like, how did it exactly happen? Like, was it a, where did it come out of?
I mean, it was sort of a string of events, and the show was already a hit. I was a senior in college when it was a hit.
Okay.
And I remember going, geez, this is like a huge deal.
Yeah.
And it was, wasn't until the second season that I got on the show. And it was like, well, I get to join like, you know, like One Direction or something. And by the time I got to the final season, this would have been last year around this time, I finally said, you know what, I got nothing to lose. I went to Ryan Murphy, or the big boss man. I was like, what do you think of the idea of writing a song for this? I'd write it for Leah, and we'll just see how it goes. If you don't like it, my feelings won't be hurt. So I ended up writing what would be Lea Michele's last song on the show ever. And
it had a lot of depth to it.
That was so fun, because I was writing specifically for her, so I kind of had a lot of the grunt work done. I didn't have to like look into my soul. It's like writing for her, and to get to that level was extremely gratifying. And it was very encouraging as a songwriter. I was like, I guess like this is something that I might want to do more and more.
I have a new record. I just started releasing a couple songs this year, and I'm going to be releasing more
it's
next
on Vagrant,
year.
Right?
Yeah, on Vagrant Records.
That's a cool company, man.
Yeah, I really dig them, and they have like a, you know, I'm like an indie person at heart, like always been.
I'm excited.
Yeah, me too.
As an LP fan, I'm very
thanks,
excited
man.
For this record.
As a Darren fan, I'm excited for your new record too.
Yeah, one of these days I'll get around to that.
Well,
I'm not.
It's coming. It's
coming. When I'm not gallivanting around as an actor somewhere in the world.
But it's nice. You get everything. You get to do it all.
Yeah, it is nice.
Let's talk about LA for a second. I feel like, you know, I'm a New Yorker, but like I feel like LA, the music muse, is so deep for me. Like I feel it more. It's more palpable here for
me. Well, I think there is a thing here. This is for music. There's the history, and obviously as an actor, which is a whole other side of this conversation.
Yeah, I mean Hollywood. Like I mean, for an actor, I trip out on like the Hollywood actor kind of like heritage of this. I live in a silent film star's house.
Really?
Yeah, it's like this woman off.
Is that star still
Paula
alive?
Paula Negri. No, she's
I'm living with a silent film star. She's 113.
Totally.
She doesn't say much, but that's always worked for her.
She's in the basement.
Yeah.
Yeah, no.
Should we play the uke?
Let's play some uke, man. Let's do it. Let's rock it.
I think we should preface this with like actors in the past like want to learn the song before this so they don't make an ass of themselves.
Yeah.
I like making an ass of myself. I do it for a living, so it was very important to me as I looked down the barrel. It was important to me not to learn this song. I don't know what the song is, and I don't really know how to play chords.
And it's a Rihanna song.
Okay.
It was on her album Loud. And
I guess I missed her uke album.
Yeah.
I missed that cut.
I'm just seeing that right now.
Yeah.
It's all kind of
like
wrong.
Super sexy outfit, but just like a little uke. That sounds like a joke, but we could be all sitting on a gold mine.
Rihanna's like,
So you were, so it was a track. So you were,
yeah.
You were supposed to write top line with these guys.
Yes, we did it with these guys, the Runners. It's me and my friend Stacey Barth. And
yeah, if I hear it, I have a feeling I might recognize
it was a single. It was the last single on that record. And there's one little part that has like a chorus of like friends kind of going,
That was all the homies that came in.
Yeah, that was like my friends, her friends, and everybody came in. So it was a memorable, fun session.
Let's just play this song.
Let's play this song.
Because we could talk for hours and hours and hours.
Yes, but, I know. Like, it could go on forever.
Let's give the people what they want.
Burning like embers, falling tender, longing for the days of no surrender years ago. And will you know? What's up, man?
What up, dude? I was enjoying that.
But this song is fun to play on ukulele, and it's yeah, I was just going to teach it to you on that.
Let's do it.
Brought you one of the custom ukes.
Great, thank you. Look at these for your Harry Potter fans.
That one was dropped on its head, though. It's basically just E, D, A. And we can start it like, we'd be like, yeah.
You're not going to give me the...
On this part, for the whole beginning of the chorus, it stays on that E for two bars, and then the chorus is same.
That wasn't the chorus?
I mean, then the verse is the same chorus. Jesus!
But it's a fuller form. It's verse two, three, four, one, two, three, four.
Yeah, I mean, we could do the other verse.
Yeah. You want to count me in? Three, four.
Cheers to the freaking weekend, I drank to that, yeah. Oh, let the Jameson sink in, I drank to that, yeah. Don't let the bastards get you down, turn it around with another round. There's a party at the bar, everybody put your glasses up, and I drank to that, yeah. I drank to that. Everybody's vibing, so don't nobody start a fight. Yeah, cheers to the freaking weekend. I'm trying to that, yeah. Oh, let the Jameson sink in. I'm trying to that, yeah. Don't let the bastards get you down. Turn it around with another round. Everybody's at the bar, everybody put their glasses. The freaking weekend, I drank to that, yeah. Oh, let the Jameson sink in, I drank to that, yeah. Don't let the bastards get you down, turn it around with another round. There's a party at the bar, everybody put your glasses up, and I'll drink to that, yeah. I'll drink to that.
I'll drink to that.
Yeah.
But where are the drinks though? Like for real though. Like where's that situation? Is that happening?